So it's another day and another wet one. But no matter how bad the weather, there's no denying that the colours are fantastic. And I would say that this year, although it's been a terrible year for many, many things, as far as I can remember, this seems to be one of the best years in a long time for autumn colours. Because, my God, it's just phenomenal and it's just ongoing, you know? They don't seem to be fading, which is fantastic. Now, in today's video, we are going to be shooting film, and I've got with me a couple of different cameras and one unbelievable lens. So, yeah, looking forward to today's video. Nice, peaceful shoot in an autumnal woodland. It's going to be cool, but let me show you what I've brought with me. So I have with me two camera systems. I've got the Hasselblad 501cm, which shoots 6x6 square medium format images. And I think that's what I'm most looking forward to using. I think there's gonna be lots of potential in the woods around me for square images. I do love a square. And I've also brought with me another insert, which contains my Fuji GX617 medium format panoramic camera, with just the 90mm lens. It's the only lens I have for it. And I'm quite excited for trying to shoot some autumnal panoramic images. Now, I kind of feel like the last time I went out with that camera, I made all the mistakes that it's possible to make. So hopefully today, especially in the woods where it's nice and slow, hopefully I won't make any mistakes. That's the plan. So I've found my first image that I'll be shooting today. And it's one that I spotted yesterday. Now this area of woodland that I'm in, I've been returning to time and time again, because every time I come, I'm just blown away by the color and it seems to keep improving. And while scouting out yesterday, I spotted this tree here. I believe this is a beech tree. And it just looks like an explosion. You know, you wouldn't be forgiven for thinking that the tree had, you know, been nuked or something, and there's just explosion of colour, which is just fantastic. And it really stands out in this forest. And as you're walking around, it jumps out at you. It's so vibrant and rich. And to me, it just seems like the perfect opportunity to not only get the most out of Velvia, but get the most out of a square format camera, because this composition very much suits a square format. So I've been eyeing up the tree, had a good walk around, and finally settled on this composition. Nothing clever, there's nothing clever here. It is pretty much fill the frame with the tree and just be mindful of the background and what may distract, such as sky, dominant trees, things poking into the side of your frame, like this kind of thing here. I am struggling in the rain, although it's not raining too heavily. The trees are sopping wet and they're dripping water everywhere. My camera's wet. I managed to keep the lens dry, or the front element of the lens dry, so that's good. So yeah, slightly challenging working in rain. It always is. But all in all, we've got the first shot in the bag and I'm very, very happy with it. Well, I say that, I haven't even got the film processed yet, so yeah, I'm confident, shall we say. And let's hope it came out nicely. But we never do know. Right, time to move on and see if we can shoot something else.
Bloody rain.
Ourselves a bit of a problem here. Hey guys, am I allowed through? So I was listening to a current affairs radio program yesterday of all days, where they discussed various political topics as well as other stuff, and one of the topics they were talking about was the amount of deaths there have been in the UK because of cows in fields where they meet public footpaths. So I was a bit nervous passing those guys, but they didn't move an inch, they just seemed incredibly placid.
This is a Carl Zeiss 350mm tele super chromat lens, and it was kindly lent to me by the guys over at Hasselblad, and boy was I grateful, because there's no way that I could afford to buy one of these bad boys.
So it feels like there are lots of opportunities all around me, and I think there are. So from where I am, within a few hundred yards, hopefully we'll get more shots, but what caught my eye was this insane flash of luminous colour on the other side of the valley. And it's miles away, and you know, I'd never normally think about shooting it with this camera, but this does give me the perfect opportunity to break out the long lens, old Big Bertha here. So I thought, you know, why not fire off a frame on this? To be honest, I don't think it's the best image in the world, but it is something that caught my eye and something that I hesitated on. Should I shoot it? Shouldn't I shoot it? And I've learned in the past that it's often better to shoot something, you know, if you're a bit unsure, go for it anyway. What's the harm? So I've got this lens set to f16, focused on the trees. And at f16, it's given me an exposure time of a quarter second. So that is dialed in. So I'm really unsure if this is the best photograph in the world, but it's not going to do any harm in taking it and having a look. So we're now getting into the early evening light, and the cloud is breaking up, so we are getting nice light coming through. Ah, yes. Cool, let's go see if we can make a nice autumn panorama. So I forgot to mention that if you are enjoying this video, I've just broken the microphone, that's why I'm being so gentle with the camera. If you are enjoying this video, please do give it a like. It's a huge boost to the channel. You know, just it's the easiest thing you can do to support the channel is to hit the like button. This is the viewfinder for my panoramic camera. Very handy in that I can keep it in my top pocket, and then if I think I've got an image, pull it out, have a quick look around without having to dig out the camera to make sure. And I am now at the beech tree. The beech tree is the first subject that I photographed with the square camera. Only this time, I'm on the other side of it. And I have to say, because it's such a vibrant, explosive subject, works really well as a panorama because you have this big expanse of space with this pow, you know what I mean? Like right in the middle of this, right in the middle of the shot. So I'm pretty excited to set up and shoot this. Although the wind's picking up, and I know we're gonna be in long exposure territory, so yeah, we'll have to see. I have to say, I think this camera is faster to load than the Hasselblad. It feels a lot less fiddly. So I framed up my composition. I don't know if you can tell, there's a glow on my face. That's from the ambient light hitting the clouds behind you. It's washing down on the scene. Wow, it's really kicking off now. Now, originally I wanted to shoot this at f32, but that unfortunately would give me a 4 minute exposure once you've taken into account the center filter. Hang on, I can do this, I can walk and talk. So, I'm taking a shot now. So I wanted to take a shot at f32, but unfortunately with the center filter and everything taken into account, it would have been a 4 minute exposure. So I've opened my aperture to f16, and instead I'm gonna shoot a 1 minute exposure. But the problem is it's windy. So, I mean, it's going to be soft. No matter what happens, it's going to be soft. So, yeah, we'll call it a creative shot. But, right, so apologies about that. The memory card on this camera was full, which actually is the indication of a good day, I think. The light was fantastic. There's this beautiful warm glow over the scene. And in the time that it's taken me to pop a new memory card in, that glow has gone. So I'm just going to have that one image. I think I will move on and see if I can find somewhere that's a bit more sheltered, perhaps, or less windy. So we'll pop that image on screen, the only one. So we better hope I got it right. Yeah, this is a little bit awkward, but me and that Fuji GX617 just can't seem to get along. So I'm going to put that image on screen now. So as you can see, that image didn't work out. It's completely overexposed and there is no detail at all on this piece of film. Now, when I shot that image in the woodland, that was one of four frames that roll of film can take. So I only took this one woodland shot. I went home and I thought to myself, I need to shoot three more frames to finish off the roll and I can send it to the lab to be developed. So went to my local beach for a beautiful sunrise, had the GoPro strapped to my chest, glorious colors, and shot what I thought was a gorgeous sunrise with images that were sure to be pure perfection. And then when I got the film back from the lab, not only did we have this error, which I couldn't fathom. I couldn't fathom how I'd made such a metering error. This isn't just overexposed, this is completely gone. And, you know, I started to question myself, did I make any mistakes? I watched the film back, I didn't make any mistakes. My metering now is pretty good, I've got to say. So I'm getting better and better. And then when I looked at the images from the beach that I shot, they were bizarre, man. They were really bizarre. One image was half overexposed. The other images were overlapping one another, and the film was a mess, and it just didn't make sense. I couldn't quite figure out what had happened. So I spoke to
Tim Parkin, who's a fantastic film photographer. He has a drum scanning business, which, by the way, I should say, that first image of the beech tree, I got that drum scanned, which is why you can see such incredible details. If you do want to get some film drum scanned, I'll make sure I link to Tim's drum scanning website below. Anyway, I digress. I had a word with Tim, and he said, it looks like you've got a sticky shutter. So after a bit of investigation on that Fuji camera, I realised that it did in fact have a sticky shutter, which explains this. It explains why this went so horribly wrong. What happens is you take an image and the shutter opens, and when you release the shutter, it closes, right? And that's your exposure. Only this time, the shutter wasn't closing, so I took that 1 minute exposure. And then I just, oh, great, I'm done. Turn around, pack away my little video camera, start, moving things around. All the while, the Fuji GX617 was continuing to expose this frame. Massive failure of the camera. Now, it is an old camera. I did buy it secondhand, but I did buy it from a reputable camera shop called Park Cameras here in the UK, and it comes with a six-month warranty. So I've sent that camera off, packed it up, sent it away for repair. So hopefully it's going to come back to me as good as new. And I promise that on this channel one day we are going to have the perfect photo shoot with that camera. And we are going to extract all of the potential because it's capable of amazing things. It's just my luck with that camera so far has not been great. So there you go, that's how we are ending today's video. I do hope you've enjoyed it. My book and calendar are available if you're looking for gifts for Christmas. Thank you guys for your time and for watching this video. And until next time, bye for now. So we're in bulb mode, and if I cock the shutter, then take a picture, and now I'm just gonna release, and obviously it sticks open as you can see there.